Thank you. folks, just a word of warning, the trees down this next road are really sort of bunching in, so just keep your heads in at all times and just try to make sure you don't lose a head or anything like that, okay?
No, it's all right. bit of a violent way, yeah. We're in a place called West Lavington. We're in a place called West Lavington. Somewhere outside Bournemouth, somewhere, it seems to be. Because we're on. Well, we can only go as fast as the bus is going. Yeah, and if you're coming and grab the table, we should be hopefully. I'm not too sure because we're outside of Warminster just as yet. So we should hopefully be. Thank you.
four next door in, but stand A, that's that big green bus there, okay?
Thank you.
first place anywhere in the world to have a cash machine there. July 1967.
Oh, I can't remember.
Enfield.
Oh, Enfield.
Barclays Bank Enfield Town.
All right, yes. Yeah.
It's the first cash machine. Which is also where the colour television was invented. By Ferguson's.
Oh, yes.
Which is now a Morrison supermarket.
Really?
Well, I don't think Ferguson doesn't exist except name now, does it?
No, that's true.
It's owned by the Chinese, they own all those names.
Yeah. Enfield, that was the one that
just choose where we are. They're still walking.
From where?
From Bourne Wood.
Yes.
Yes.
307 goes from Barnet. 121 goes from Turbo, then up through Oakland and down to Enfield.
We have the 121.
Oh, 292,
I used to get.
From London, it's the
live in Elm Street,
London, the night bus is the M29.
Yeah.
Where do you used to live?
Yeah,
but that's
in Elm Street, Bournemouth.
Oh, right. Oh, I've worked there loads of times in East Enders.
Oh, right, yes.
Yeah, I've been in loads of episodes of East Enders.
Oh,
okay. Did you know that that village, or that set, it's built 9/10 full size.
If they get there and turn left, they can go to the
yes.
Because that makes everybody stand out in the scenes.
So it's nice,
isn't it?
Yeah.
Not a lot of people know that.
I'm finding an Uber coming.
Well, my mate who used to live over the road. He took me to a friend's house who was in the block of flats behind the thing when I went down there years ago. Here we go, hang on to your house.
Well, I don't know if I'm right, but I was told that the East Enders set is built on the old set from the they burnt Atlanta and gone with the wind from there. I don't know how true that is, but I was told that that's where the set was. They burnt Atlanta. Yeah, they only burnt it once.
Yeah, that's we didn't work that right.
No,
I don't know.
No, we didn't work that.
I was told I have no proof evidence.
I don't think Gone with the Wind was filmed in Elm Street.
No, I think I actually just used it for that particular scene, the burning of the lantern.
I've got disoriented.
I don't know. Someone might have been winding me up when they told me that.
Yeah, I don't remember that being in the folklore that we had when I was at school there. So, but you never know. You can't know everything. I remember
it was a deserted set before they built the East Enders set.
Yes, it was, but it was also the ACB Studios.
Oh, yes.
On the chain for
When I was at school, we did the Panda Trophy competition.
Oh, right.
When I was at school, about when I was 10 or 11. And one of the trips that we went to was the ACB Studios.
A number of public guests.
And we met Arthur Lowe and Marty Kane.
What made you move then? Fair enough.
So we went back up to Yorkshire.
And this brings back memories.
Oh yeah.
That was 70.
Have you been back down to
one of these? We spent 3 years in Elm Street.
Is your point?
And we left in 77. I moved back down to London in 86. Back up from London, from the south anyway.
Where did you move back down to London?
First month I was in a basement flat in Mayfair.
Right.
And I moved out to Crouch End.
Which is just up the road from me?
Yeah. And moved out to Parliament Green.
Did you know Crouch End is where Queen came from? They went to Haunty Art College.
Yeah. That's right, yes they did. Yeah. Yeah, we did. Yeah, moved to Palmer Green. Then we moved out.
Oh, getting even closer, mate.
Yeah. Then we moved to Luton. And I moved to Bedford.
Slowly migrated.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. And then came back up here from Bedford.
Is this your first time, Dennis, in my bus?
Yeah. If you're not guessed by the way we're going, where do we go now?
Wow.
I don't think
it'll
be the last.
No.
Yeah, it's very interesting, the charities that the money goes to as well, which is off the tree.
What do they go
for? Well, a lot of it does go to the military charities.
Oh yeah, good.
Which is good. Yeah, and you know, it seems a very worthy cause. I was just intrigued by when you know, the buses all provided free apparently.
Oh, brilliant.
Because it's all gone to charity. They come from all different places.
Yeah.
Some are privately owned.
Yeah.
And they donate and they don't.
Yeah.
Which I think is, so the whole concept of it seems very admirable. I was very suspicious, I thought it's just a commercial enterprise, but when you dig into it, it seems very genuine. So a lot of these things aren't, so you know, you've got this. Yeah. In the media, you've always got that cynicism when you come to these things and stuff like that.
Say one thing, that one rose from crowds good to do, weren't they? Really like them in
time. Oh, that's true. Yeah, we go down to Swanage every year and we get one of these to go from Bournemouth to Swanage.
Quite often, this one.
Yeah, we've got this one a few times.
Yeah, it was interesting when I was talking to someone, they told me where I can't even remember all the place the buses came from now. It's a whole sort of collaboration that buses are drawn in for the day, sort of thing.
Brilliant.
I wonder
if I can get Malcolm to bring one of these
down. Yeah, because these old Red Room bus, the buses have got quite a value on them.
Yeah.
They're iconic, everyone knows them all over the world. All our bendy buses are in India. They're all there. They've dumped them all over there.
Good. Best place for us. Actually, not all of them, because I know where one is, one's in one's New York.
Is it? What, yes. British bendy bus?
Yeah.
But in India,
my other half's ex-boss has one.
They're a hoot in India because there's so many people sitting on top of them there as well.
Wild things.
Yeah.
Oh,
they were just a complete. As soon as the replacement route passed the bus, they were too big for London. They've done away with it fairly slowly. They've already replaced it.
It's one thing I would never understand when I was a kid, we were talking back in the 70s, and Oxford Council, being as they were back then, trying to eradicate cars even then. Persuade people got to hand woven raffia bicycles. They bought all the bus lanes to park and hide in when there were capacity issues, so they borrowed a load of these bendy buses from Germany. Well, the two problems that one, they were left hand drivers, and now but at least they could get into the railway station with the same capacity. And the thing is, they did a conclusive bit of research for 12 months and found out they're absolutely completely unconscious for the UK road. So they've all that research, and then Sheffield did it when these are useless.
Yeah.
And then, you know, it's almost like we've got the bus company saying, yes, we've learned from our mistakes.
It's brown envelope stopping a job in someone's pocket, isn't it?
Yeah, well, that's about it. Well, I mean, Leeds didn't do too badly because we had the FTR.
I don't know what they are.
They were specially designed by Wright Bus. They were something carded. That's what's right, it's one thing. There was some in York. And we have some in Leeds. And they were a bendy bus. And in fact, I've actually got some in Las Vegas.
What is that doing there?
I know, I was just.
Yes, they have. I go to Vegas a lot, so yes,
yeah, the streamlined bendy buses.
Yes.
Yeah.
The ones that go up and down the strip and everything.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I suppose they don't have to go around the corner, just alright. Right. Go in a straight line up and down the strip.
Oh, it's the other one, yeah.
That's what I was just waiting for. It's like, oh. Since we've like regularly been crap on both of them, I was like, get a photograph of the two of them side by side.
Because the new route master bus, when they first started in London, the air conditioning packed up there, they couldn't handle it, the air conditioning air went wrong.
Yeah.
Just a fortune for them.
Well, they sent one up to Leeds.
Because they had the back doors, and
yeah.
They never used them, so real script just jumped on and never paid, and you just sort of didn't even think about it. They just like had a lot of tapping button,
yeah.
Because the guys were just going, was just piling on late, and they were not paying, and the driver's down the front of the engine coming out.
Well, they used to shut the doors about 7 o'clock.
That's
at
right.
Night,
yes.
When there ceased to be a crew bus. Oh, just the lane bus there.
Oh. Exciting.
Oh, we do it, yeah. I'd like to see what. So they finish here and then it's from here as a different bus, according to the timetable.
Someone will tell us, I'm sure. I think it's a bit of a moving feast, to be honest.
That one's
one was still broken down.
That broke down before we came.